The Dow had an amazing run in 2017, but in the beginning of 2018, it saw its biggest percentage drop since August 2011. And news outlets couldn't get enough of it.
Dow's up over 300 points.
The Dow was down triple digits.
Up 283 points.
We are at session lows.
But here's the thing. As much as we love to cover the Dow, it's actually a very controversial market measure. The Dow is comprised of 30 of some of the most widely known companies and represents industries ranging from financial services and healthcare to technology and telecommunications. But many say it's impossible to adequately represent our modern, diversified market with so few stocks. That's why they like the S&P 500, comprised of 500 companies. And the issues don't stop there. The Dow is also a price-weighted index, meaning that it's affected only by changes in stock prices, not market value. So what does that mean? Let's say these are average stock prices on the Dow. This line running between them represents an average price that determines the Dow number. So if stocks that are close in price to most others change, that line won't move much. But if stocks with a much higher price start changing, that line can swing dramatically, even if that expensive stock has a lower market value than all the others. The S&P 500, on the other hand, is weighted by market capitalization.
So this makes it a much better representation of the overall U.S. stock market. The bigger the market cap of a company is, the bigger its impact on the index will be. For example, a company worth $800 billion will have a much greater impact on the overall direction of the index than, say, a company worth $80 billion, regardless of the stock price.
Another issue is how stocks are added and booted from the Dow. Plummeting stock prices, tarnished reputations, or government aid might lead a company to be dropped, but there's no set criteria. It's said committee members prefer the ratio between the highest share price and the lowest share price to be no more than 10 to 1, but this ratio is often ignored. So if the Dow is a bad market measure, why does everyone still use it? One reason is the index has a long and rich history. Created in 1896, the Dow is the oldest and best-known stock market index, and it's well understood on Main Street as well as Wall Street. But just remember this. When you're talking about the Dow, you're talking about the Dow. You're not necessarily talking about the broader market.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.